And welcome back. You know, the Charleston County Parks Holiday Festival of Lights has just been voted the third best light display in the country. Let's give it up for them. Yes. And the good news is there's still time to get out and take in the spectacular sights over at the James Island County Park. And our friend Sarah Reynolds joins us with more. Sarah, so good to see you.
Thanks for having
seems
me.
Seems like I just saw you like a couple of nights ago.
Yes,
it seems
I did.
Like it. I know.
I think I live at the Festival of Lights right now.
And so how was that when you got the news yesterday when it came in that we were in third, you know, we took third place?
We were so excited. We were actually in the running. There were 20 nominees from throughout the country, and it's a contest that was sponsored by USA Today.
Yeah.
And we were really just trying to get in the top 10. And I know a lot of people out there voted for us. Mm-hmm. We had so many people who were out there supporting us and voting for us.
Yay.
So yeah, we made number 3 in the nation. We were absolutely thrilled. So,
And for good reason too. You guys are celebrating your 25th anniversary this year. And the lights are going to be open until January 1st. So if you haven't gotten a chance to get out there, you can do so. And also, if you'd like to get $5 off of your admission, what do folks need to do?
Monday through Thursday. So, I mean, that's even going to be next week during Christmas. Those will be busy days.
Of course,
I recommend going this week if you can, Monday through Thursday. If you bring a canned or non-perishable food item, we're collecting them at the gate. You'll get $5 off your admission, and everything we collect is going to the Lowcountry Food Bank. So even if you're coming on another night, bring a canned food or non-perishable food item, because we're donating it all to the Lowcountry
Food Bank. And you have a goal of raising how many pounds?
25,000 pounds for our 25th anniversary. We're
awesome.
A little below that now, so
come on,
us.
Folks.
Yeah, bring a can.
Go in those cupboards and those green beans that have been sitting way in the back. He's like, man, am I gonna fix this for dinner? No, I'm not. But I'm telling you, there's so much to do out there. I had a chance to spend a couple of hours with Sarah the other night, and I didn't have my kids with me. You know, they're teenagers now, but I'm sure they'd love it. But I was like a kid again. It brought back that spirit that I remember feeling as a child around this time.
Yes, it definitely gets you in the Christmas spirit.
Yeah.
And we have so much to do. In addition to just the driving tour, we have marshmallow roasting,
which
Tessa
we did. You had already done it? Had you
yes.
already done it? Okay. My first time she introduced me to roasted marshmallows. Yeah.
Really fun. We have gift shops. Santa's there until December 23rd.
That's right. Taking pictures.
If the kids still have the last minute wish list to get in
That's
there.
That's right.
We have the festival train. We have carousel. We have the climbing wall out there. So we have entertainment on select
nights. Chocolate and ginger,
hot chocolate
and gingerbread funnel cakes.
Yes. That's new this year. It's
Someone
delicious.
Said, ooh, yes. So definitely try that. And if you're looking to take your family photo, holiday photo, and you haven't done it yet, you guys have a really unique way to do that too, right?
We do. We have a new photo op area this year. Basically, it's in front of a green screen, so you look like you are sitting in Santa's sleigh flying across Charleston.
I can
it's
see
really
that now.
Funny.
You can do something really cool, like throwing your arms out of the sleigh and just being really silly, giving you an opportunity to do that. Now, also, what about unwrapped toys?
We are collecting for Toys for Tots in the sweet shop, which is where you can get some hot chocolate and you can get some of your baked goods in there.
Yeah.
So if you have, if you'd like to donate, bring a new unwrapped toy, just bring it in the festival and drop it off in the sweet shop.
And I think that's awesome. And real quick, the light display contest for our kids in the schools.
Yes.
You're taking submissions now for next year's Light Festival.
Correct. If you go to our website, it's holidayfestivaloflights.com. You can download an entry form. It's for kids 12 and under. If you know any kids who have any ideas for what they would like to see at the Festival of Lights next year, you can submit a drawing there.
All righty. So if you want to get more details about what's going on at the Holiday Festival of Lights, you see the website there, charlestoncountyparks.com. And I do encourage you to get out and walk it. I mean, it just feels like you're not even in Charleston or on James Island at
it's
all.
So
just
much fun.
You're just transported to this winter wonderland where everything's Christmas and laughter and joy and everything. That just took me back there, and I think I want to do that. So we do want to send you, we have a giveaway to let you know about. Be the first caller, 849-2535, for your chance to win one vehicle admission pass to the Holiday Festival of Lights at James Island County Park. Got to be 18 years of age, live within the ABC News 4 viewing area. The total value of this prize is $15. Again, the number 849-2535. The phone's already ringing off the hook for your chance to win. Stay with us. We're back in a moment. Thanks, Sarah.
Thank you.